In a podcast, no one can hear you scream. Or can they?
I swear to God, Joan.
I'm going to keep saying it no matter how many times you re-record it. And if I don't stop talking now, you won't be able to edit it out. So with that in mind, welcome to Castle Run, the podcast from outer space.
That's not really funny.
Exactly what I just said.
I think we mean it differently, though.
I'm your co-host, Joan Green, suggesting that everyone see the F out and try to enjoy themselves a bit more. Demeter?
Hi. I'm Demeter Johnson, and I'm having a really good time.
First of all, before we go any further, I, producer, Harper Johnson, no relation, would like to make it very clear again that this is not a failure on my part to properly navigate the required software for the class.
Nobody said it was.
You guys did.
A lot. Last time, and I edited out because it was off topic, but I guess...
Now it is our topic. Inspired by events on this very podcast, today's episode will focus on one of my personal favorite tropes from Hollywood lore, the intercepted radio signal.
Broadcast signal intrusion.
Sure.
Just to be like, right.
Cool story, bro. So if you're just now catching up with Castle Run, our first two episodes have been a bit odd on the audio front. Lots of weird beeps and chatter. We're still getting to the bottom, but what we do know is that this has been happening. So what we know is that this has been happening ever since we started recording the podcast.
But we know what it's not.
I'll wait. May I continue? So, anywho, if you've been wondering about those crazy screechy noises during the show, you're not alone. Today, we'll be talking about a few possible explanations and whether or not, as some movies have suggested, it could be extraterrestrial communication.
I can't. I physically cannot with you.
Honey, get in line.
It's not aliens.
Then explain those noises. Huh? What in this wide world, animal or machine, makes a sound like that?
There's an incredibly rude response sitting on my tongue, but it's a school assignment, and I've never actually met your mother.
Do you guys still want me to read the thing?
Yes, Demeter. Since you're clearly the only person here who knows what they're talking about, why don't you start us off?
Yeah. Basically, broadcast signal intrusion is when a broadcasting signal or wave is overpowered by a competing signal on the same frequency. Should I keep going? Basically, broadcast signal intrusion...
Not in the beginning!
Got it. Okay. Broadcast signal intrusion can happen accidentally, like a transmitter accidentally directs competing frequencies from two different origin points into shared airspace.
Ah, like when you get CB radio breaking into AM and FM, right? Smoking the Bandit? Hello? Movie podcast, have you guys ever even seen a movie? Philistines.
Okay, but then it can also be purposeful, like when you hijack an existing signal with an FM transmitter or breaking into the transmitter area or splicing audio directly.
Whoa. So crazy and deeply specific. But I also see from your notes that Harper is pointing at with like so much emphasis that broadcast signal interruption, it's not really an issue in the digital age. Why is that?
Because tons of stuff is cloud-based and downloadable, like TV or podcast episodes.
So the only time I gotta watch out for the old B.S.I. is when I'm live-streaming the Oscars and just as Lupita's name gets called.
I don't understand, because we don't record live. We pre-record and then I thoroughly edit everything.
Right. So the issue isn't happening when people listen to the actual episode.
Lol. People. Hi, Professor Pasco.
Sure. But in that case, the problem happens between the editing and the upload.
And
it's likely a Wi-Fi connectivity issue.
Thank you.
That still makes it your fault, Harper. You're the one who keeps uploading stuff at like 3 in the morning in the back fucking corner of Lead.
One, watch your mouth.
Two, if you knew anything about my life, which you don't, so feel free to listen real quick, I would upload it in other places, but I hate being in my dorm because I hate my roommate, and the only place I feel safe is the lo- I take 7 classes, I work so hard, I hate my roommate, and you know I have ADHD because you've said it a million times, and my brain only works at certain parts of the day, so I can't upload it until my brain works again. 3, I'm cutting all of this.
1, fuck no. 2, nobody needs to take 7 classes, you are sick. And 3, maybe it's all your weird cutting that makes the file upload funky.
That's not... You have no scientific evidence for that, and Demeter says it's a broadcast signal intruder.
Intrusion.
But perhaps intruder is closer to the truth. Okay, guys, hear me out, but if we're taking inspo from movies
okay,
here...
I'm cutting this, all of this.
You can't, because this is the movie part, and film/science is in the metadata.
Good point, Joan. But even though it's super funny, aliens probably aren't the problem with our podcast uploads.
Then why not? In movies, it's always aliens. Like,
is that Game of Thrones?
You're disgusting.
It's not aliens.
Thank you, Demeter.
Then what is it?
Excuse me?
You're the fancy science brain. Explain what it is.
I already did.
Yeah, but what's making those noises? Why isn't every file uploaded from lead all janked up? Whose signal is intruding on us?
I supplied a hypothesis. You're asking for a theory. I'm not. There's not enough data.
So it could still be supernatural. There is major filmic precedent.
Dude, no.
White noise, contact, frequency. Just name a few.
Aliens don't exist.
You're killing it today.
How do you know? You just said you couldn't explain what's happening, which means you can't explain why it doesn't have a ufological explanation.
Please tell me this is still your super funny joke.
I mean, yeah, but also...
Oh my god. You're one of them.
What? A viewer of the documentary Witness of Another World, starring survivor Juan Perez and streaming on Amazon Prime?
I am so deeply unsurprised.
Seriously, Harper? You don't think there's any possibility of intelligent life anywhere else in the galaxy?
It's not anywhere else in the galaxy. It's our spring semester podcast project.
In Nevada. The American Southwest is like Florida for aliens. They have bungalows and shit.
There are no aliens on the Wi-Fi.
Then I will ask again, what do you think is...
It's just weird computer noises or a camera somewhere is messed up. Or it's like, you know, some government thing.
Say more.
Shut up.
No, I'm serious.
Well, like, I don't know. There's all kinds of stuff out in the desert. Everyone knows that. Facilities and plants and, you know, stuff.
And what kind of facility makes sounds like the ones we're picking up?
I mean, it could be anything. Maybe there's a reason it's in the desert. Maybe, like, they're hiding...
A remote location?
Exactly. For security.
Have you ever heard of MKUltra?
Oh my god, exactly. They did, like, experiments with hallucinogenics and, like, chemical weapons, I think, in South Dakota.
On the last episode, it totally could have been someone tripping out, and that someone doesn't necessarily have to be human.
Both of you are stupid people.
Okay, strong take.
I mean, I'm not being serious.
You need to be really, truly, totally stupid to believe in any of that stuff, okay? Just, you know, for reference.
Excuse me, there is a ton of proven facts.
Harper, just upload it from your dorm, okay? Or Grant. Nobody is ever there, so the signal's always strong, okay?
Okay.
So we're done now.
Are we, though?
I really think we are.
Harper, thoughts and or spine?
Just do the thing.
Sure. My fucking pleasure. That's it for today, guys. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Joanne, last survivor of the Nostromo, signing off.
Listening to POD 115, Hustle Run. Be sure to visit pod115.com to join the conversation. This is show notes and bonus content. Is for a grade. Could you head over to iTunes, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, or wherever you heard us and subscribe, rate, and review? that would be really, really helpful. Thanks, and we'll see you for our next episode.